With the prevailing weather condition in the country, attention has been focused to disaster management. The Auditor General also issued a report regarding natural hazards in Sri Lanka.
The Global Climate Risk Index 2020, published by the environmental think tank German Watch, ranked Sri Lanka the sixth most affected country by weather-related loss events such as storms, floods and heat waves in 2018. Japan, the Philippines, Germany, Madagascar and India makes up the top five countries affected the most. The National Audit Office points out, due to such environmental risks the country is currently facing, Sri Lanka must pay more attention towards disaster management. However, amendments to the Sri Lanka Disaster Management Act, which provides legal cover for natural disasters, is yet to be completed. The Auditor General's department further points out the National Building Research Organization does not have any powers to enforce legal action, as the institute is not a legitimate institution. It added, even though the Disaster Management Act identifies 21 natural disasters, increase in global temperature and increase in sea levels is not included. The report states that in the past year, disaster risk reduction only focused on floods, landslides and droughts. It adds the preparation of the National Disaster Management Plan for the period between 2018 and 2030 commenced in 2017 but was not completed even by the end of last year, resulting in the failure to implement several disaster management plans. The construction of houses for 167 families in the Kaluthara district and 151 families in the Ratnapura district that were affected in the 2017 floods is yet to be completed. The report states in 2017, 238 families in the Kandy district were identified as residents of high-risk zones, while 125 families of the 238 lacked housing facilities. The Auditor General points out relief to those affected by the drought were also not provided in the right manner. The report said in 2018, 451,224 individuals from 14 districts were identified as beneficiaries of drought relief, and on the 25th of September 2018, 700 million rupees was disbursed to the district secretariats for this purpose. However, 15 days later, upon the instructions of the secretary to the Ministry of Disaster Management, these funds were reclaimed. The report further reveals the account maintained by the ministry to provide relief to victims also received contributions from foreign and local donors. However, as at the 6th of August 2018, the accounts posted a balance of 294.43 million rupees. These unutilized funds also include the $100 million received by the Chinese government. It further pointed out plans were not in place for 278 disaster management projects, for which 480 million rupees was allocated. Even though 474.43 million rupees was provided to the divisional secretariats to implement 278 disaster management projects in 2018, only 361.49 million rupees had been utilized. The report further reveals about a Doppler radar system that was purchased at a cost of 320 million rupees as per a budget proposal in 2006. The Auditor General points out this machine was sent to the factory for renovation purposes in 2017. However, no progress in this regard has been submitted. Observations also said the cost of 408.82 million rupees that was incurred to install this machine during the end of 2018 was omitted from the accounts. The people strongly believe that the Auditor General should continue to reveal such matters to the general public.